Fish friends, how's it going? Hope you're doing well. My name is Zenzo with Tozawa Tanks. A lot of you guys have been following my Mudskipper tank from the beginning when I built it, to me finding Mudskippers and buying them, to adding the figure eight puffer, to the last ordeal where I got another Mudskipper, and that's a whole nother story. I'll put a link up here. If you've been following, you kind of know what's going on. So for those of you that don't know, I have three Mudskippers in my brackish paludarium, along with a figure eight puffer. This is brackish water, which is a mixture of salt water and fresh water. My three Mudskippers are named Larry, Curly, and Moan. They've been doing excellent. They eat healthy, they're active, they're playful. They fight a little bit, just kind of like the Three Stooges, but for the most part, they're pretty fun. So I do have a fourth Mudskipper. That fourth Mudskipper is named Shemp. So it kind of goes along with the Three Stooges, the theme, Larry, Curly, and Moe, the original three Mudskippers, and then now we have Shemp. So Shemp is doing well. So Shemp was, he arrived in not the best situation, as many of you do know. I had to quickly make sure that he was okay. I kept him separate for a long time. About 3.5 weeks or so, I kept him in his own small, separate little brackish system that I made just for him. I made sure to monitor him to make sure that he was active, to make sure that he was putting on weight and size, and making sure that he was eating. The most important thing that I also wanted to do was make sure that he was healthy so that he wouldn't cause any issues with the other Mudskippers, and also to be large enough to kind of fend for himself and, you know, just kind of add some weight to him. He ate baby crickets, he ate mealworms, he ate bloodworms, he ate freeze-dried mysis shrimp. So every time I put food in this tank, I would go back after a few minutes to check to make sure he ate it, and sure enough, he did. Now, he wasn't as active as eating as these guys, so Larry, Curly, and Moe, as soon as I put food in the tank, they're on top of it, they attack it. In fact, if I like take like a little dropper, so when I feed them, I'll feed like, bloodworms or, things like that using these little droppers, and they'll actually jump up and like attack the dropper. So I think I'm going to try to feed them from my hand sometime in the near future. So anyway, so Shemp, he would eat, he just wasn't attacking the food the same way. And observing him, he kind of always was kind of hiding or sitting in the back of the little tank that I made him, and I thought maybe it's a social issue. Now, I don't know a whole lot about the social hierarchy of Mudskippers. What I have learned is that the three original Mudskippers I have, they have kind of set up kind of a hierarchy where the largest one will display his colors and the other two kind of fall in line. So when he raises his dorsal fin, they kind of back off. I did have a little bit of fighting earlier on where they would kind of lip lock like fish do, and but they haven't done that in quite a while. So anyway, so they are very active and they attack the food. Shemp wasn't doing the same way, but I thought maybe he was kind of bored or lonely, so I decided it was time to put him in the tank with the other three guys. So what I did is I kind of took my experience of keeping a lot of fish. For those of you that don't know, I have 35 fish tanks. A lot of them are African cichlid tanks. African cichlids can be very, very aggressive towards one another, and when you add new fish to an African cichlid tank, it's very common for that new fish to get picked on to where it basically dies because just it gets exhausted from having to fend off attacks all the time. One of the tricks that I have with adding African cichlids to aquariums is doing it during a water change, kind of moving some things around so that it kind of seems like a new tank, a new environment, and also I'll do some feeding at that same time so they kind of get a little distracted, and also add other fish at the same time. So if I'm going to add African cichlids to a tank, I'll do 3, 4, 5 at a time. But what I did with Shemp is I decided I was going to do it during a water change. So I did a water change. I've talked about how to do this in other videos, and I'll share some clips here. I'll probably speed it up, but anyway, I'll share some clips of me doing the water change while I was preparing to add Shemp to this tank. And what I also wanted to do is I kind of wanted to experiment with Poe, and I also wanted to experiment with the Mudskippers on how they would interact with other fish besides just the puffer and just other Mudskippers. So I do have the figure eight puffer in the brackish tank, and he is doing great. Poe loves to eat. He's very friendly, will come right up to the glass, and will just kind of beg for food. But I haven't had any other fish in the tank. A lot of you had made suggestions on putting other fish in there, from everything from different types of gobies, like dike gobies and dragon gobies. Some of those get too big and they would predate on what I have in there already, to other puffers, to mollies and guppies. and just a whole lot of other fish that we could try in a brackish tank. But I can't put them in there just because there's not enough water. Even though it's a 75 gallon tank, there's only about 25 to 30 gallons of water. So I'm kind of limited on the fish that I can put in there. One of the fish that was highly recommended, and it was one of the fish that I wanted to do at the very beginning, are the bumblebee goby. Now the bumblebee goby, they do well in a large number. They're really cool to look at, they're pretty, and I thought that their behavior would do well for a brackish tank. However, what I did worry about was two things. One, I didn't want them to get picked on by the puffer, so I thought, you know, maybe the puffer would get a little bit nippy, and maybe I would get some, you know, bumblebee gobies that might get killed. But I was more concerned about the mudskippers eating the gobies. Now, even though they're both gobies, mudskippers are gobies, the mudskippers, they have quite a large appetite, and they've got pretty big mouths. So what I was worried about is if I put in the bumblebee gobies would stay pretty small, that they would get predated on by the mudskippers when the mudskippers go down deep in the water. Now, most of the times the mudskippers will kind of spend their time at the surface, on the land, but sometimes what they'll do is they'll kind of hang out on either the island or on the little beach there, and they'll peer down in the water, and if they see something that they want, they'll jump and get it. So I was worried that the bumblebee gobies would get eaten. What I decided to do was do a little bit of a test. Now, a lot of you know that guppies are able to live and thrive in brackish water. I have some guppies, I got them from a friend of mine, and I decided to put them in the brackish tank. Now, before I did that, I wanted to get them acclimated to the salinity. I keep these at 1.008, the brackish tank that is. So I took my 20-gallon, one of my 20-gallon tanks, I had some guppies in there, and they had spawned, so I just took some adults, raised the salinity so that I matched the salinity from the guppy tank to the brackish tank here, and I put the guppies in at that same time when I was doing the water change and adding shemp. Well, shemp did great. Shemp was jumping around, hiding, and it's been a few hours now, and he is doing really well, so he has fit in. What I did notice is that the mudskippers, they are kind of social, and they do kind of hang out together, even though they kind of squabble at times. So what I noticed is when I put shemp in the tank, that he became a lot more active than when he was in his own little small tank down below. So hopefully he continues with that trend and continues to be active and continues to grow and interact with Larry, Curly, and Moe. Now, the guppies didn't fare so well. I put the guppies in, they were fine with the water, they were swimming around, they were nibbling on some food, and it wasn't that long that they were in there, so after about 10 minutes or so, I put 7 in there, after about 10 minutes, I couldn't find one of them, and I said, well, maybe he's hiding, because I have so much rock work in here, there's coral and all kinds of things that they can kind of go back in a cave and get pretty much lost. So I thought, maybe it's lost. So I kept kind of looking at everything. I went upstairs for about 10 minutes, had to do a couple errands, and I came back down just to check on them again, and I only saw 5. Well, what I noticed is that 2 of the mudskippers, and I don't know if it was Larry and Curly or Moe and Larry or one of the 2 or 2 of the 3, they had pretty big bellies. And then I saw a guppy head sticking out of the mouth of one of the mudskippers. So unfortunately, the guppies did not work well in this tank. I'm glad they were just some guppies. I know, what, you know, I don't like feeding my fish live fish, so I wasn't doing that on purpose. I immediately took them out, so I captured all the adults, put them back in the guppy tank, so they're fine. There are no more guppies in here at all, except for the ones that are in the bellies of the 2 mudskippers. So it was a good test. So definitely what I found out is that they will predate on small fish that happen to be in the tank. So I can't have anything that small. Now, the puffer is fine. The puffer is much, much larger than the guppies, and we way too big. In fact, they interact all the time together down in the water, and they leave each other alone. They're pretty close to the same size as far as like girth. The puffer's a little bit bigger, actually. And so anyway, that's what I found out, is I can't put guppies with these guys, which means I can't do the bumblebee gobies or anything small like that. So anything that I put in this tank is going to have to be a solid 2 inches or so. I could do some mollies, but I don't know if I want to do that. So for now, it's just going to be Poe and the 4 Stooges. Hey guys, I hope you like this video. If you do, it's a big help if you guys give it a like, a thumbs up. And if you want to comment down below, I love reading your comments. I try to respond to a lot of the comments, or at least acknowledge that I've read them, so that you guys know that I appreciate all of your feedback and your comments. That's all I had for now. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.